Let's talk about LCD backlighting and how it affects your picture quality. In a conventional LCD television, we use thin fluorescent tubes to create the light source, and that light goes through the panel. There's many layers, including a polarizer, glass panel, color filters, the liquid crystals that actually control the amount of light that's let through, and the backlight. The color of the set, how much you can reproduce, really depends on this backlight. As well, controlling that backlight will really affect your contrast. Here's a Bravia that's been cut apart, and you can see all those layers from the last picture on a working set. You can see the backlighting in the back, and the first thing you notice is how really bright it is. Those little fluorescent tubes are very similar with what you probably have in your office or home for fluorescent lighting. What's interesting here is that the LCD crystals don't actually stop all the light. That light is so bright and intense that we have to use polarizers to assist the liquid crystals to help create that color. And you can see here when you have two polarized sheets, as you turn them cross-angled to each other, it blocks light. So the design of this part of the panel really makes a big difference in terms of what kind of contrast you're going to get, how far you put the backlight back, how bright you make it, will all affect that picture quality. What's really neat is as you turn the final polarizer around, all the pieces come into alignment and you actually see the color. And that's really the magic of LCD, is that you get these great, beautiful, vivid colors. So the liquid crystals actually twist and they allow the light to pass through the polarizers. And because we have a color filter in there as well, we get the full rich color, we get the great contrast, and that's the main principle of how the LCD panel works. So let's have a look at some other backlighting systems. HCFL is a more efficient version of the traditional fluorescent lamp that uses half the power while giving you the full bright picture. Another lighting system is to use a grid of LEDs to create your picture. In Sony's Triluminos backlighting, you actually use two greens, a red, and a blue to give you the full color spectrum of light. What's neat about this system is that it is the exact opposite of a camera. You can choose the exact wavelengths of color for the blue, the red, and the green that are being captured by a broadcast camera. And that way you have really exceptional control of the light. What's great is you can change the brightness of each one of these clusters, and it allows you to therefore really work on the contrast of the screen. And I'll show you a little video to see how that works. This is a simulation to give you an idea of how local dimming works. Here's a picture of some kids playing soccer, and the backlight, all the clusters would light up at different intensities like this, depending on what's happening in the scene. So darker areas are lit less and brighter areas are lit more. We'll fade it together to give you an idea so you can really see. You can see how the sky at the top, the clusters are really bright. And as we move in quickly and pull back, you can see that horizon line and the tall buildings in the back as the kids play around. Even on the line, you can see how the backlighting is working to improve the contrast ratio. I'll play it a couple more times here just so you can get a sense of how the local dimming moving in real time with the picture and the Bravia engine and all the image processing is working to give you the ultimate picture on an LCD. LED really is the state of the art, and local dimming takes that to the next level. Finally, in the lighting, we have edge LED. Instead of having the fluorescent tubes behind the LCD, you have the edges having little LED. White LED is a single color broad frequency that shine up into light guides from the edges. So there's some technology in terms of making that light uniform and brilliant. It allows you to have these amazing thin form factors, and the new LEDs have energy consumption as low as our HCFL backlight, which has been the standard in terms of energy efficiency up to this point. Because they're LEDs as well, they're mercury free, which is again a little better for the environment when you're looking to dispose and recycle the set at the end of its life. So that's the whole range of lighting: standard CCFLs, the HCFLs, which are a higher efficiency backlighting, the LEDs used as a grid behind the TV with a triluminous using three colors, and the edge lit as well. Each one gives you a slightly different form factor and allows engineers to play with the design of the TV to maximize the contrast and the color.